gradually, during our chronic and systematic homeopathic treatment, after some months or years, we expect all other improvements that I have told you about. That is, lessening of the chronic predispositions, and so on. The general miasmatic and constitutional characteristics, more balanced, and so on. Now, let's be more practical. According to this criteria, I have decided if my patient is better, the same, or worse, and how much better or how much worse. If I have a patient that is, he comes to me after the first month and he is better 3, that is, he is more than, what does better 3 means? He is more than 70%, more than 60%, 70% better to all his symptoms and to his psychological states. If he is better more than 70%, then he is better 3. What do? I will not repeat the same remedy. I will not change the remedy. I will wait. Kant says, wait, wait, wait. And he's right about it. Because if you are in a hurry to make him better the soonest possible, and you decide what is soonest possible, you are wrong. The nature will decide. The patient's organism will decide. The life will decide. The only thing you have to do is push the best way. Push an energy push by the energy homeopathic remedy. So if he is better 3 during the first month, on the second prescription, you will not give anything. If you if you do a parallel treatment with Schussler salts, you may change the Schussler salts accordingly. But concerning homeopathic treatment, you will never change the treatment. If he is better 3, you will wait. You will wait. Wait, wait, according to Gant, and he's right. You will wait until he relapses, and if he relapses. If he goes well, you will not give anything else and he will get cured. Only a few cases are given once the homeopathic remedy and they are well and they don't come back to you, or they come to you back to you in 1 month, in second, 2 months, 3 months, and you just consult them to continue not drinking coffee and other things, and you don't repeat the same remedy or another remedy. They are the people that have very few chronic predispositions and they've got very good health. These are rare individuals nowadays. If he gets better 2, what does better 2 mean? That he is better from 30% better to 60-65% better. Then he is better 2, both physically and psychologically. Then you wait. And you wait. You may not have to wait for long, because your patient may relapse after a while, or you may need to repeat the same remedy or another remedy according to what is the similium at the time he has the relapse? What if he is better one? What does better one means? From 10 to 30% improvement. Physically and psychologically, I repeat, as a whole. Then there are some selections when he's better one. The first thing I do when he's better one is to reconfirm my prescription, reconfirm if this was the similimum or if this was a relative constitutional remedy. If it is the similimum, I will have to reconfirm it. How do I reconfirm it? By again asking and taking the case once more and reconfirming that he is indeed phosphorus. And that is his similimum. Because there are times that I may prescribe the similimum, but because his disease and his illness was very bad, because he had a great burden and he was greatly ill, during the first month I only have a slight improvement. It is normal to have a slight improvement in persons that are very troubled, very burdened, have many chronic predispositions, suffer from severe and chronic illnesses, or have a weak organism, or live in adverse environment. You have a patient that has an ulcer of the stomach, and he works a lot, and eats junk food, and not at the proper times. Then we have adverse conditions, and his stomach, although I gave the similimum, will get slightly better the first month. Or his psychology will get slightly better because he has a lot of stressful factors. He lives at an adverse environment. Then, although I have given the similimum, I may have a slight improvement. Or the nature of the illness. I have a person that was suffers from psychosis 30 years and is on antipsychotic drugs. He was not married, he didn't have children, he stays with his suppressive mother, and he lives in an adverse environment. Then I don't expect, I expect gradual changes, both psychologically and physically. But then I will examine if what I have prescribed was not the similimum, but a relative, a close one to the similimum. I didn't hit the center, I hit next to the center. So, if it was a relative and not the similimum, a relative remedy, then I expect a palliation. A palliation of both, only of physical symptoms, or a palliation of physical and psychological symptoms. My patient gets a little bit improved, but it is more than certain that after some weeks or months, he will go back to his past state, before he came to me, or he will get better two, worse one. So, when I see an improvement, better three or better two, I am sure that I gave the right remedy and I wait. When I see a better one, I have to reconfirm that it was the similimum. Or if I decide that it wasn't the similimum, but it was a relative remedy and I have a palliation, I may do two things. Wait and see, and if he relapses, then prescribe again another remedy that suits the patient best, that is the similimum. I will do another effort to prescribe the similimum, or not wait and prescribe try to prescribe again the similimum. I believe we are clear what one should do when he has these cases. Things are more clear here, and we are more than happy that our patient is getting better. But what about if our patient is the same? Before we go to the same, what if our patient during the treatment was better three or two or one, and then he got worse three or worse two or worse one? In this case, we have to find out what happens. One case, if he was better three, if he was better three, worse three, during the first month, the first thing that comes to my mind is antidoting. Antidote. He may have drunk coffee or things that have caffeine in them, and he was my therapeutic effort was antidoted, was neutralized, was spoiled. So, whenever I see this, I try asking my patient, have you drunk coffee, Coca-Cola? Have you taken a painkiller that has caffeine in it? Have you used anything that has caffeine in it? When I find out that he was better three, he drank coffee and he was three again, then what do? I check if my patient is still phosphorus or pulsatilla or what I have prescribed, and I repeat, and if he's still the same concerning constitution, I repeat the remedy. If he was better three, worse two. Excuse me. The first thing is to check about antidotes. A second case is that it was the right remedy, but he faced very severe and adverse stressful factors. His wife died, his child died, he was fired from work, he had an economic disaster, he was severely shaken by a stressful event. Then, although he got a very important improvement, if after the stress he's worse three, I am sure that he got, it was the right remedy because he was better three, and after the stressful factor, he lost all the improvement. So, the first thing that I do is again reconfirm, and if still my patient is under the influence of the same constitution, his phosphorus, then I repeat phosphorus. But many times, after such a stressful great event, he may change. For example, you may have a phosphorus patient, but after the death of his child or after a love disappointment, he may develop another acute constitution, let's say Ignacia. And then I will prescribe according to the present picture and give the acute similimum. These are the two possible cases when we have better three, worse three. What about if I have better three, worse two? I again check the above cases, A and B. Okay. And I decide what to do accordingly. If I have better three, worse one, apart from the above cases, A and B, I have another case. I didn't have any antidote, I didn't have any severe adverse stress. He got better three, worse one, because of some factors, because of the stressful way that we live in. He didn't have a severe stressful event, but he lives stressfully. So, I gave him a great push, he got a lot better, but now, because of the unnatural way of living that we all live, he got a little bit relapse, but he's still better too. So, stressful life conditions, or he suffers from a severe illness and chronic illness, and so we need time to eradicate this problem, and so we may have again some symptoms. If I have a patient that has migraines for 30 years and every day, the last 2 years, he has every day a migraine, I may find out that during the first month, during the first 15-20 days, she had no headache at all. But then, or she had only one mild headache. But now, the last week, she started having two headaches and a little bit more severe. Then, what do? I may wait and see, or I may repeat the original remedy if he is still at the same original remedy. Mostly I wait and see. If my patient was better too, worse too, then I examine the same cases that I told you before, that is antidote or extreme events. And I do the same thing. If he is at the similimum, the same similimum, I repeat. If he is better too, worse one. I examine these two factors, and maybe I repeat if he is the same, under the influence of the same constitution. And then I examine if what I gave was a palliative one. And what I consider better to was not better to, but was better one. And I had a palliative action. So I try to find the similimum. What about if he's better one? We have talked about it. And then we go to the case where he is the same. A big zero. His physical symptoms are the same. His psychological symptoms are the same. Nothing has changed. The first thing that I examine is antidote. I gave him the correct similimum remedy, but he kept drinking coffee all during the treatment, and caffeine never left our therapeutic action due changes. The patient has spoiled the case by drinking coffee and all other antidotes. So, if we have such a case, we reconfirm that we have given the similimum, and we repeat it if we are sure that it was a similimum. Or we may change it and try to find the similimum if we decide that we haven't given the similimum. He may have drunk coffee, but we may have not given the similimum, because there are many times that we give the similimum, the patient drinks coffee, but he doesn't spoil the action of the similimum. And many times the action of the similimum is so strong that coffee doesn't affect it, or affect it only a little. So in such a case, we have to be sure that we gave the similimum. Not to say he drank coffee, so it was a similimum, and all troubles are, we have to blame coffee. Another case is that, another option, when the patient is exactly the same, is that we haven't given the simile. And not only we haven't given the similimum, but we haven't given the palliative also. We haven't given the relative remedy. We have given a remedy that has nothing to do with the patient. Not relative, not similimum. Then, what we do is take the case again. From the scratch, take the case from scratch in order to try to be objective and try to give the similimum. Is there another case? Yes. We may have given the similimum, but we have adverse extreme factors. I have given him the similimum, and the next day, or the same day, his child has died. He had a great love disappointed. He separated after 10 years of marriage. And his wife took the children with her and he's left alone. If such great adverse extreme factors happen the minute he starts the treatment, maybe the similimum could not have helped him. So what do we do in such cases? We take the case again from scratch and see if we are sure that it was the similimum, we repeat it. If we are not sure of the similimum, we try to find the similimum. Or if he has changed and due to the extreme factor he is under the influence of an acute new constitution, let's say Ignatia, Aconitum and so on, then we prescribe the acute similium. And there is another factor. The patient, the antidote, the remedy was not manufactured from the pharmaceutical company or the pharmacy correctly. The pharmacist was wrong and has given another remedy, not the one that I have prescribed. Or the remedy that I have prescribed was not prepared well from the pharmaceutical company. And so it is as if my patient hasn't taken the remedy. This is a difficult case because you have to be sure you take the case again from scratch and have to come to a conclusion. Am I sure that I have given the right remedy? If I am sure, and I'm sure that my patient hasn't taken caffeine and these two factors are not the case, then I tell him to go to another change the pharmacy. Change the pharmacy. And give again, repeat the same remedy. In order to decide here, you have to be a very good and experienced homeopathic doctor. It is easy to say, I'm not to blame, the pharmacy didn't prepare the remedy well. You have taken coffee. We have to be strict with ourselves. We have to examine all factors, the pharmacist, the patient, and my prescription. You have, excuse me for the phrase, you have to have balls in order to decide that the remedy was not correctly prepared. The only way, you don't have a way to know it. You only know it if you exclude your action. If you are sure that you gave the simile, then you repeat it from another pharmacy. Now, let's go to a more difficult case. You give the remedy, and the patient is worse. Worse one, worse two, worse one, or worse two. You start thinking, what's the matter? There are many options. First of all, when we say worse one or two, we mean both physically and psychologically. If the patient is worse physically on functional problems, that is a headache, or his rash, his skin problem gets worse, but psychologically he is better, one, two, or three, then I may have a case of therapeutic aggravation. Nevertheless, this aggravation will last this physical head worse of functional problems, headache or rash, will last only a few days or a few weeks if it is a rash. And at the same time, after the first days, my patient will be better psychologically and in other symptoms. In such a case, you've got a therapeutic aggravation, and you are sure that it is an aggravation, a therapeutic aggravation, because he gets better. So, in such a case, you don't have worse one or two. This is not a deterioration, it's an improvement. So, I may have told you that this is an option, but it is not. If you have this, you say that he's better. You never say that he's worse. But I have to say it because there is such a confusion of what is a therapeutic aggravation. We will talk about it later. So, worse one or two? The first case is that we didn't give the similimum, the patient was, when he came to us, was deteriorating, was at a down course, and we didn't stop this falling, and he got worse. He was down. I gave a remedy that was not the similimum, nothing changed to his course, and he kept falling. And he came to me after 1 month worse. So, I again take the case from scratch and try to give the similimum. Another case is that I gave the similimum, but the pharmacy did not give the similimum. I prescribed the similimum, but the pharmacy, the remedy was not well prepared, or he gave him a wrong remedy. So he kept his downfall course. Or I gave him the similimum, but he drank coffee and he antidoted the treatment. Immediately after starting the remedy, the same day or 1 or 2 days after receiving the remedy, he kept drinking coffee. And we have this downfall course again. So I reconfirm the similimum and repeat it. There is another option. I didn't give the similimum, and instead I gave an irrelevant remedy, and I repeated it high, very high, again and again. If I have a patient that was natrum muriaticum, I had such cases, and instead of giving natrum muriaticum, it was natrum muriaticum, I gave valeriana 1 mL or 10 mL or 50 mL once, or I gave valeriana 1 mL every day. Then, if my patient is sensitive, if he has a sensitive vital force, I may have produced what I call a therapeutic, a pharmaceutical proving. I have caused a pharmaceutical proving. It's a proving not by coarse materials, by raw materials, minerals or plants. It's a proving that has been done by giving energy remedies that were very high enough, were irrelevant of the patient's constitution, and I have repeated it very often. So I have caused, my patient is still natrum muriaticum, but I have put a layer above him, a proving layer that has to do with valeriana. And the patient will not be improved, and he may, his physical symptoms may and his psychological symptoms may continue the downfall course, and on top of that, he is going to have some symptoms or characteristics of the valeriana constitution, that of the valeriana proving, on top of the other, that will make him feel bad. What do I do in such cases? I will not repeat, I will stop the remedy that I gave, and I will try to take the case again and prescribe the similimum. If I give the similimum, then all these the natural illness will get well, and the artificial illness that I have caused to my patient, the proving picture, will go away. Some homeopathic colleagues say that in such a case you should give coffee to the patient in order to antidote the remedy that you have given, the wrong remedy that you have given. My experience of 30 years of clinical practice tells me that you shouldn't do that. You needn't do that. If you give the similimum, then all this will subside. Sometimes the proving, the pharmaceutical proving will last for some days and then it will subside by itself. We will say more about this when we will talk about the pharmaceutical proving. There is another case, better one, worse one or two. I had an initial slight improvement, worse one, better one, and then in a month, worse one, two, or worse one or two. Then we may have the following options. What I have given was not the Sibelium but a relative one. I had the palliation and then the patient was following the downfall course that he had before I treated him. In such a case, I take the case again from scratch and try to give the Sibelium. The second case is that I have given the Sibelium, but then he had extremely adverse conditions, stressful factors, and so he got worse. What I do is reconfirm that it was the Sibelium and repeat it or change it if I am not sure. Another case is that I have given the Sibelium, but then because I have a severe case, cancer, insanity, a very severe case, then I have this deterioration. In such a case, I have to reconfirm that I gave the Sibelium and repeat it or change it if I am not sure. There is another case that I didn't give the Sibelium, but the patient got well because of positive events that happened to him, or because of the placebo effect, that is, he came to me, he got hopes that he will be improved, especially in psychological problems, and although he didn't take the Sibelium, due to positive events and the positive attitude of him, because he hoped he will get a little better and then worse. We will have to take the case and try to give the Sibelium. So, these are the possible outcomes of my treatment to the patient when he comes to me for follow-up after 1 month of treatment. And I should act accordingly. The only thing that can clear things is to take the case again.